Hi everyone, welcome to Be Efficient TV. The mission of this web TV show is to boost the efficiency of your business and life with tips and tricks from leading experts. And today we are recording a special series with the Speak in Dubai with Melissa Hell. She is a media expert and TV personality. She's the host of the Ripple Effect international TV show. Welcome to the show, Melissa.
Thank you for having me.
How are you doing today?
I'm great. I'm very excited to be here.
My pleasure. How did you start in the TV world?
You know, that's an interesting story. I actually wrote a book first, and that book led to my desire to speak, and so I began public speaking. That gave me an opportunity to be the co-host of a cable television show. And from there, what I found is that I wanted to have more control over the messaging and the content of that show. So I knew that I was going to have to change the vehicle that I was using at that time and create something of my own that was a little bit more me. That's how I found my way into television and hosting my own show.
How long you spend time in terms of years in the cable TV industry?
Cable TV, I was about a year, I would say. It was about a year. The name of the show was The Hollywood Entrepreneur. We discussed branding and the hits and the misses of celebrity brands. I knew that for me, what I really wanted to talk about was their personal stories, why some of these celebrities were struggling with their brands. We're usually tied to personal struggles, either loss or addictions or just not really functioning well in life. And that to me was the bigger story. So the Ripple Effect is really about that. It's about the power of our stories and how they relate to other people and how those things that we can learn from each other can change the lives of other people. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to positively impact the lives of other people by highlighting the everyday person doing some pretty extraordinary things with the intention to help.
How do you compare the future or see the future between the traditional media and the internet now?
You know, the internet is changing everything. I know that right now the big trend is to go from traditional broadcast and that circle of influence, which is very fixed. You know, the programming is the programming on these traditional networks. Let's call them the cable networks or the satellite networks, if you will. Online television gives you the option of really talking to very specific people about interest. So it's niche market, so topic-driven content, bird watching, quilting, yachting, you know, you can find a TV show online that has that content, and the viewership is incredible. Right now, just in the U.S. alone, the online market, or OTT, which is considered over-the-top, so over-the-top broadcasting, or traditional broadcasting, is 170.6 million viewers per month, and it's growing at an average rate of 12% per year. So the statistics are definitely showing that online television is not going anywhere. If anything, it's going to absolutely replace what we know as television today. And what is OTT distribution? Well, think of Amazon, think of Apple, think of, you know, Hulu, Roku, and Netflix. These are subscription-based, so membership-based consumption. So it's highly specialized, highly individualized content that meets the needs of the viewers. They pick what they want to watch by picking the content of the stations that
they're watching. So you feel it's going more on demand, people just subscribing on demand? Then why most of the experts, authors, like when they want to launch a product, they always go back to the traditional media for interviews?
You know what? I think that speaks to your body of work. I think that speaks to why people out there would want to watch you on demand. I think that gives you the credibility. It kind of answers the question of why you. Why me? Well, I have been on CNBC. Why me? Because I have been on Fox. Why me? Because I've done some things that have set me apart. I've written 3 books. I'm getting ready to launch my own course. I've developed my own online television show. So I'm giving people my body of work, which is answering the question of why they might want to watch me, but it won't hold their interest if I'm not giving them something that really speaks to them.
But I mean that they are going back to the traditional media because of the traffic. I mean, there are still traffic there more than most of the platforms online.
Yeah, I think that there's nothing wrong with doing it that way. But I believe that the trend is going to prove that online OTT distribution is going to be a very lucrative and very profitable way of monetizing your message, leveraging your solution systems, your learning systems, and or your products. It just is. And the sponsorship and the advertising dollars, those budgets are shrinking. It's very expensive to advertise to a broad base of people. But if you know that you want to speak to quilters, if I'm a sewing company and I've got sewing machines I want to sell, why would I talk to football players? Why would I talk to bird watchers? I want to talk to quilters. I want to talk to seamstresses. So if I can find online programming and they have distribution and they've got a reach of 5 million a week, 5 million viewers a week, why wouldn't I want to advertise with a show that's speaking directly to those people that I'm hoping to reach? It's like going from being a cannonball to being a sniper. I can go right to the people that they're looking for and distribute the content, and they get the benefit of my viewership, which is about 5.5 million people per week.
What's the platforms that you are in now in terms of
the different platforms? I'm featured on WBTVN Network and Bon Bon Network. Those are technically stations that are then distributed to Apple, Roku, Hulu, Netflix, Chromecast, it goes on and on. My monthly viewership reach is about 25 million people and holding and growing, which is very exciting for me.
Most of the viewers now saying, wow, especially the experts, authors, how do you do that? Like if someone have a show and want to get it into those channels and platforms.
I would encourage them to reach out to me. I have a course that's going to be launched here in the next 90 days to teach them exactly how to do that, how to launch your own online television show with guaranteed distribution of at least 25 million or more per month.
How do you see the vision for your show? Where you wanna, like the avatars, the people that you wanna, demographics that's gonna view the show?
You know,
and where do you wanna get with the show?
I'm looking for people that have a message. I'm all about heart connections. You know, my personal story and how I ended up in television is, it's very personal. And if it's okay, I'd like to share that.
Sure.
My four-year-old son passed away when he passed away at the age of 4.5 to an accidental drowning. I fell asleep one morning, and I had two little boys at the time. And that experience changed my life. It devastated my life. Losing a child, you don't necessarily think that it's going to unveil your life's purpose, but for me it did. What I found is in one of the darkest moments of my life, it was the kindness of a woman, and all I know is her name is Teresa. She wrote me a letter. And in that letter, she said to me, if you choose, you can have your best life ever. This does not have to be the end. It does not have to be this sad and dark experience. It can be the catapult into all of your greatness. And it confused me at the time, but over time, I understood exactly what she meant. I have a wisdom and an insight that other people don't. I know that that letter changed my life. It saved my life, in fact. And now I spend my life trying to serve other people. I want to help make life better for other people. How do I do that with a television show? I feature everyday people doing extraordinary things to improve the lives of other people. I'm all about the power of kindness and the importance of being good. Doing good things. Random acts of kindness are so needed in this world. I see it cross over into business. I see it cross over into how we just deal with each other and interacting with each other. That's why I wanted to create an international show, because I wanted to get outside of my immediate, you know, circle of influence, and I really wanted to make a global change. I'm one person, but I'm one person reaching millions of people every week, and my story does make a difference.
So you think you can make people choose happiness, and this is what they should do?
I think that you can model a life of happiness, and for me, that model centers around serving. I find great satisfaction in knowing that I'm making a difference. When I talk about my loss, the loss of my son to drowning, when I'm talking about water safety, I know that there's a parent out there that's listening, and they're going to change the way that they do things. They're going to add those door locks. They're going to make sure that their entries and their exits in their home are secure so that they never have to go through what I've gone through. And that makes me feel incredibly good. Does it take away all of the pain? No. But does it help me find meaning in that experience? Absolutely. And that meaning changed my life. It's the absolute driving force of why I do everything that I do.
How people can find you?
People can find me by going to my website, melissahull.com, and that's melissahull.com.
Thank you so much, Melissa. I really appreciate it.
I appreciate you having me here. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thanks, everyone. See you soon with another leading expert.